In Justice vs. the Masters of the Universe, issue 1 sees Zodak remembering the history of his world. Eternia and the ongoing battle, He-Man and Skeletor are locked in as he races across the galaxy to return home as a great darkness is hot on his heels. On Eternia, He-Man does battle with the Faker as his friends and allies battle his minions. Faker is hit through a castle wall where he finds Prince Adam's family and pretends to be the real He-Man and the real Prince Adam. The trick doesn't last long as Battle Cat pounces on him and rips him to shreds. Adam, however, is attacked by his own people and told the kingdom was better with Faker leading it since he raised a mystic wall to keep the Dark Hemisphere out, among other things. Others say that their world is constantly under attack and the world needs a strong leader, and He-Man and Prince Adam aren't that. Powering down, Adam and his friends leave as Zatanna and Swamp Thing watch, saying they have finally found the right guy for their job. Later on, Adam reunites with his mother, who is happy her son saved them, and that's all that matters. Adam says that they liked Faker and were okay living in a police state, but his mother reminds him that the people in the castle are a very vocal minority, and most of the kingdom is celebrating Faker being defeated. Adam wonders, now that everyone knows he's He-Man, does he really need his Prince Adam identity? As his mother tells him to take some time for himself, Adam is kidnapped by Swamp Thing and delivered to Zatanna, who introduces him to Batman and his team. Adam demands to know who they are, and Batman says that they are from Earth and gets Cyborg to show Adam the history of their world, beginning with Superman killing the Joker and ending with Brainiac's defeat and Superman now using Brainiac's technology to re-establish his defeated regime. Batman says that Superman's weakness is magic and he's been monitoring worlds within the multiverse like Eternia to make sure no magic escapes or is used against him. And thanks to what Adam told his people, Batman wants Adam to join him and defeat Superman. Teela launches a surprise attack on the team to defend her master and fights them until Mossman and Swamp Thing arrive and tell her that the team mean well since they both serve the Green and they know that Batman's stories are truthful. On Earth, some kids walk down the rainy crime alley talking about Superman's new police state. They are suddenly attacked by Copperhead, who demands that they stop thinking and judges them guilty of a pre-crime. Wonder Woman allows her to attack the powerless boys as she reports to Superman, telling her the Kryptek armor on Copperhead worked and kept her in check. Superman is glad Diana is devoted to efficiency since that's what his new regime is running on, and it works when he and the Brainiac tech-controlled Batman work together. Skeletor arrives and talks with Superman, saying that he was once a great collector of magical artifacts before he crashed on Earth, and while that was in his past, he still senses artifacts and he has found one on the child Copperhead attacked. He asks Superman to get Diana to bring him the sneakers of the boy, who is revealed to be Freddy Freeman. Adam contacts the Sorceress of Castle Grayskull, telling her he wishes to travel to Earth and help save the place his mother came from and restore it to the way she remembers it. She tells Adam that he need not worry about the kingdom when he leaves, as Man-at-Arms and the others can defend it in his absence. Adam returns to Batman and agrees to join him, as does Teela. Cyborg, Swamp Thing, and Starfire stay behind to help guard the kingdom, and with the teams assembled, Adam transforms into He-Man and they head off on their adventure. Nearing Eternia, Zodak is attacked by the Black Racer, who destroys his vehicle and leaves him at the mercy of his master, Darkseid. Injustice vs. Masters of the Universe issue 1 was quite the surprise to me, seeing as I had no idea this was coming out, or that it was going to be written by the great Tim Seeley. This issue was a great little treasure trove of cool things that happened in the Injustice universe, as well as the He-Man universe and the other tie-ins he's had recently with stuff like Thundercats. I enjoyed Tim weaving both these universes together so well, and using the correct characters to bridge them together, like Swamp Thing and Zatanna and everything. I thought that was really smart. They're just not Batman teleporting over to Eternia or something. It was like thought put into it. The story is also surprisingly topical, involving dictators, police states, and much, much more. And the great thing is, it's not overt. It's not hitting you over the head with it, and it's just utilizing it since it makes sense for both these worlds and where both these worlds are at this point in time. I'm really looking forward to this 6-part series and what Tim Seeley has to offer for us. I'm going to give this issue a 9 out of 10.
Hey everyone, thanks for watching my newest video. If you enjoyed it, you might also like to check out my other reviews here on my channel. You can also follow me on various social media platforms like Twitter by searching Matt_FOS, or even join the Comic Multiverse Discord server and chat with other comic book fans, including myself and Joel from Cape Joel. Want cheap comics and trades? Head over to the Book Depository with the link in the description to get the cheapest trades and comics around, along with free shipping anywhere in the world. Until next time, this has been Matt of the Fortress of Solitude. Thank you so much for watching.